All right, 6 days until the solar eclipse, and finding safe glasses to actually see it is proving to be kind of a challenge.
Yeah, I was at Target over the weekend. People were asking for them, and they said they didn't have them. There are some safe do-it-yourself devices, but if you get a fake pair, your eyesight could be at risk. NBC2's Brian Anderson found out where there are some glasses left and what you can do if you can't get them.
Solar eclipse glasses pretty much all look the same, but it's the lenses that you need to pay close attention to, because the only thing that you should be able to see through them is the eclipse.
Planning ahead.
Can you see anything?
Cape Coral mom Janice Kovacs stocked up on 24 solar eclipse glasses.
I'm excited.
For her Girl Scout troop.
I'm hoping that they're going to be able to see this, and it's like an aha, wow moment, and maybe say, I want to be the next astronaut.
It's a life-changing event, making these glasses a hot commodity. Ask Heather Preston at the Clusa Nature Center.
Yesterday, we had a shipment of 50 eclipse glasses come in at 3 p.m., and by 4 p.m., they were all gone. It is just crazy.
The craze creating a perfect opportunity for scammers, too.
When you put on your solar eclipse glasses, here's what you should be able to see. Nothing. But if when you put them on, they look like you're wearing sunglasses, that is a bad sign.
It's total black. I cannot see you at all.
Ophthalmologist Dr. Mark Gorvoy says you should only be able to see the eclipse.
The burn is actually a true damage to parts of the retina.
Where like a sunburn.
Kind of, yeah.
Except when it comes to your eyes being burned, the damage is permanent. So one do-it-yourself alternative involves turning your back on the eclipse.
This could be a very popular thing for people to do.
NBC2 meteorologist Jason Dunning shows us a pinhole projector.
The sun goes through a very small hole in the aluminum foil, and you see it projected on a small white piece of paper at the bottom of the box.
Bottom line, be careful.
If I have to get a headband and tape them so they stay on their face securely, because we do not want to be seeing any light. I don't want their eyes to damage.
So are there any solar eclipse glasses left to be found in Southwest Florida? Lee County libraries are out, so are Collier County libraries, unless you're attending an event there. The Clusa Nature Center has a shipment of 100 coming tomorrow, but as of this afternoon, 30 of them were already pre-sold. In the studio, Brian Anderson, NBC2.
All right, we kind of gave you a preview. The good news is you can make your own solar glasses.
In fact, as you just saw, our weather department made one. You saw Don
just
in there with a cereal box. What's he doing? It took just a couple of minutes.
It looks a little goofy here, but this is the safest way to protect your eyes on the cheap. So Peter has a piece of paper there saying the sun.
If you make the little demonstration
here, you want to have your back to the sun. You hold the viewer up to your head here, and the sunlight goes through the eye hole that you have here. If we could take graphics, meteorologist Jason Dunning built this. It's a really nice low cost way to view the eclipse for a low price. That's what you need. It breaks down step by step what you need to use to make it. That's available on a nice weather blog at nbc-2.com. But by all means, do not look directly at the total solar eclipse. You can mess up your retinas in a big way if you don't view this properly.
Yeah, even if you have a great pair of sunglasses, don't do it.
No good.
All right. Thank